Hello, and welcome to this video series on the Power BI Adoption Framework, which is about empowering every decision maker. I'm Paul.
And I'm Manu.
And in this video, we will provide our view on the different Power BI users you could have in your organization, as well as the training we recommend for them. We've identified some key roles that should be trained in order to accelerate the development of Power BI solutions. We will give you an overview of what each role entails and what training we would recommend for them. This list covers most of the training needs and scenarios that we've come across. When we've run training for these various user roles, we developed a Power BI solution for the team using their data, and then train the team on that solution. This has two benefits. The first one is that the attendees can relate to the training dataset and the business scenario, so they're a lot more attentive and involved. And the second benefit is they actually have a prototype of a working solution which they can use and extend after the training. Consumers are those typically who only consume Power BI reports and potentially interact with them by changing filters, fields, or visuals. Given that most of us interact with software throughout our working day, it's possible that people can learn to use Power BI just by launching the reports and browsing them. However, each tool is unique, and we've noticed that a quick session that provides an overview of the Power BI service, the mobile app, and other key capabilities like alerting, subscriptions, and Q&A can get people excited and interested, and it also speeds up the adoption from an end-user perspective. Analysts typically perform more detailed analysis than consumers, although they'd still be consuming a model created by somebody else. They typically do not create solutions from scratch, but are key users for BI solutions. They're a bit more advanced than the consumers, as they might download data locally and mash it up with other datasets to explore the data in more detail. Apart from the topics covered in the end user training, analysts can be trained on loading, mashing up, and modeling data, primarily because they may end up making changes to an existing solution. Analysts typically have a very good handle on data visualization, so the training should cover advanced visualization options in Power BI, including custom visuals and R visuals, and also cover the preview switches in the Power BI desktop tool, as they may be able to leverage some of those preview capabilities for advanced analysis. DAX is the language for writing calculations in Power BI. Analysts typically end up writing calculations in data models as they understand the business logic very well, so the training should cover DAX to an intermediate level. Power users are those who develop end-to-end solutions using Power BI. They're typically Excel savvy users who know how to mash up data and understand the basic concepts of modeling data. In addition to the analyst training, the training for Power users should cover the organization's governance strategy in detail, as they'll be the ones implementing it in the solutions they develop. Power BI is one of the key tools in the Microsoft Data Analytics platform. However, there are lots of other tools like SQL Server, Analysis Services, and Data Factory that can be leveraged for advanced scenarios. Power users would benefit from knowledge of those technologies as well. Power users will typically develop solutions using Power BI Desktop, so they should be provided a detailed Power BI Desktop training that covers advanced data modeling techniques and scenarios. One of the biggest strengths of Power BI is its ability to blend data from multiple sources. In reality, a lot of data cleansing and data munging is required to mash up data coming from disparate sources. There are various ways in which missing data, erroneous rows, and duplicate rows can be handled in such scenarios, and the training should ideally cover best practices for data blending. Power Query is the tool that's used for loading and cleansing data, and M is the language that the Power Query interface in Power BI Desktop uses. M is a very powerful language, and while the user interface has lots of options, advanced users can write custom M scripts to write repeatable functions. Power users should ideally have an advanced training on M and DAX. Once the solution has been developed in Power BI Desktop, Power users will typically publish it to the Power BI service for sharing with a wider audience. In order to do this, they should have a very good understanding of how they can manage dev, test, and production environments in the Power BI service, and how they can share reports more widely using app workspaces and apps. Real-time dashboards in Power BI are implemented differently and may require some developer skills, so this topic should also be covered in the training for Power users. Members of the BI development team will create data models, reports, and applications and insights for colleagues throughout the business to consume. This will enable analysts and power users to create self-service content, as well as supply interactive insights to everyone else in the organization. Typically, BI development teams have a strong data modeling skill set, so a customized training that covers Power BI specific concepts should be sufficient. As technology experts become an enabler for self-service BI, their key role is to surface a variety of data for Power BI consumption. So the training should cover best practices around developing data sources that are ready for consumption by the business. The training should also cover how the existing BI environments can be integrated with Power BI, and how the data in Power BI models can be kept current. If the BI development team has only developed on Analysis Services multidimensional cubes previously, then a module on Analysis Services tabular cubes should also be included. ALM and release management are key to DevOps, which is the new trend in the IT industry and positively impacts project release timescales, so the BI development team should also be trained on those areas.
Web development teams develop internal and external web applications for the business and can embed Power BI solutions in these web applications. This approach allows the app developers to manage security within the app, so an overview of the organizational governance and security strategy is essential. Web developers can also help develop real-time dashboards and custom visuals for Power BI. These are very specialist skills, so the training course should cover these topics only if they are required. IT teams will also play various roles in the lifecycle of a Power BI project. The operations team are responsible for keeping the lights on, so they will be the first point of contact if there are any issues with Power BI solutions. This team also typically manages the Power BI tenant settings. Ideally, this team should first undergo the end-user training so that they understand what they are managing. They should then be trained on the service management aspects of Power BI, for example, managing the tenant-level settings. The team should have a clear idea of which parts of the service are fully managed by Microsoft and how Microsoft support teams can be contacted if a support issue requires Microsoft involvement. If the organization has a premier support contract with Microsoft, then there should be a clear understanding of how it can be used. The operations team should ideally review audit logs on a regular basis or automate notifications to identify unusual behavior and have a view of how users are using the service through usage reporting. If one or more Power BI solutions connect to an on-premises database, then one or more on-premises data gateways will need to be installed in the organization's network. These gateways will need to be managed, so the IT operations team should be trained on these areas. IT minor enhancements support team are the ones who would normally take charge of any IT managed BI solutions. These solutions may have been developed by a business team, the internal BI team, or an external consultancy. A large part of the work that they do will involve enhancing solutions or solving complex issues. So this team should at least have the same skills as the power users and ideally have skills that the BI and web development teams have, like release management. These teams may need to manage data sources and gateway connections, so an understanding of these aspects of Power BI can also be very helpful. In this slide, we've summarized the license and tool requirements for the roles that we've discussed. Please feel free to pause the video and review this information. Alternatively, you can also download the slides and review this information later. Now that we've discussed the different types of roles involved in the lifecycle of a Power BI project, it is a good time to reflect on these roles and identify the roles that your organization will require in the short and the long term. The key action is to discuss and document different user types, what they need to be able to do, and what licenses and tools they require. One of the amazing things about our partner ecosystem is that our partners adapt to the change in technology quite rapidly. A lot of our partners who would have typically developed BI solutions for our customers are now actually enabling our customers to develop their own Power BI solutions through Power BI trainings. If you're looking for a partner who can offer Power BI training as a service, then please check out the marketplace. The link is in the description below. We have included a link to the slides that we've used in this presentation in the description below. Thanks for listening, and if you have any feedback or questions, please leave a comment below. See you in the next one.